Welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive studio. And joining me in studio is Rebecca Kurzweil, the CEO of Woe Is Media, as we talk a little social media within the mining world and other sectors as well. And first off, Rebecca, nice to talk to you. How are you?
I'm fabulous. Yes, happy new year.
So your company specializes in social media. You work a lot in the mining industry and other industries as well. So we thought we'd bring you in to talk a little bit about the emergence of social media within mining companies. First off, when you meet with someone, what are some of the questions that the CEOs want to learn about social media?
Oh my gosh. Well, I mean, there's what channel should they be using? That's a big one.
Right.
There's so many that you can use. And I also like to branch out outside of social media, like specifically onto stock forums as well. So I encourage companies to monitor those channels and to post in them as well and to see what the sentiment is. So they mostly want to know, like, should I be on LinkedIn? Should I be on Facebook? Should I be on Instagram? What other networks should I be monitoring?
Right.
That kind of thing. And so I do mostly encourage Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn.
Yeah.
Instagram is really image dependent and it suits some clients and not.
Yeah. And Instagram to me is more of the what are my friends doing? It's more, I find that LinkedIn is very business oriented. Twitter is somewhat more news media than everything. And I think when you're trying to stress something along of what's a project about things like that, that's what you're saying is finding those sites that would have the best track.
Absolutely. And they're used completely differently. Like Facebook and Instagram is incredible for ads. And I'm very passionate about using Facebook for lead generation. It's a great tool for that and to get email leads and help grow your email list.
Right.
There's tons of groups on Facebook as well that are investor focused, stock market groups, mining groups. I have my own mining group on exploration and mining stocks group, which I've grown, and I talk about mining stocks in those as well. Twitter is just so good for following thought leaders and influencers. I mean, the Sprott, everybody's on Twitter.
Sure.
And all the like VIRC, there's going to be that hashtag is starting to trend now, VIRC 2020.
Right.
There's constant conversation and chatter, as well as following the hashtag of your stock. So if you are the dollar sign and then
away you go.
XYZ, yeah, that's typically the conversation about your stock.
Okay. So what are the advantages for a mining company to be on social media? What are you trying to do for them?
Well, I mean, especially with mining, people want to have an inside look.
Okay.
And I know that many mining companies focus on, you know, they've got a great team, they've got great property, and a great price is the typical kind of stuff that we've talked about. So social media allows companies to actually create a connection between that management team and their investor audience and actually give them a channel to get to know, are they a thought leader or an influencer?
Right.
What are they actually, how knowledgeable are they on their...
Can a CEO post too much? Like, how detailed information do you want to get about a CEO? Because if they're learning about their company, do they want to know about what their dog did yesterday or things like that? Should there be two channels almost for a company and for a personal one?
Well, yeah, absolutely. I would keep your personal. If you're out in the public and you have a presence, then keep your personal separate from your business. Absolutely.
Right.
But it's just a great channel to show your knowledge, show your experience. I mean, a lot of these incredible CEOs or geologists, especially in the mining space, have huge track records of success. And that's really what people are investing in is, you know, they've had a track record of success before, so likely to be again in the future.
How important is visuals? Pictures,
huge.
Video,
yeah,
things
huge,
like that. It doesn't have to be long, I wouldn't think.
Huge.
Yeah.
I mean, pictures go such a long way on social media, and pictures of people go a long way. Like, that's what gets the most engagement and the most likes. People love to see you on a roadshow, on a site tour, actual photos of, you know, if you're mining rocks and, you know, of the property, maybe you're helicoptering into the site, and especially over the drill season in the summertime, typically, there's a lot of really good photography. I mean, I've worked with clients that have had professional photographers on site all season, and the type of photos that they push out are just incredible, and it gives people like an emotional connection to the company and helps it just seem more legitimate, basically.
Okay. How does a CEO get themselves into trouble on social media?
By talking too much, that's for sure. I mean, with social media comes obviously negative sentiment too. I mean, there's the good and the bad.
Right.
It's important to not be emotional and respond to negative sentiment and get yourself kind of in a in a battle with any investors.
And when the mining stocks were having a tough time, mm-hmm. you saw a lot more of that. People were upset about investments and things like that. As a CEO, do you advise your clients not to get into those kind of Twitter wars, let's say, about 100%. Stock prices and things like that?
100%. 100%. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Especially stock price. I mean, that's something you really don't want to be talking about on social media.
Right.
But it is good to address negative sentiment as well. Like, I don't think necessarily ignoring it is good, depending on like who the person is and what the sentiment necessarily is. But if someone feels like, you know, why aren't you doing this, or why haven't seen the results yet, et cetera, it's
right.
good to connect and say, you know, offer factual information if you're linking to a press release or something in SEDAR.
Right.
And just show that you're active, because that's what people want to see. Like, I've invested, or I want to invest. Are you actually mining? Like, what is the progress, and
right.
you know, what's actually
the
going on?
The drills on the ground, things like that.
Yeah.
Let's talk about that specifically, about progress and things like that. When a company is drilling, and mining companies are very tight on their budgets, obviously,
yeah.
do you have to spend a lot of money to have an impact on social media?
Oh my gosh, dollar spent. Like, if you are doing dollar spend on social media, it goes such a long way. Like, it's incredible. I mean, you can get new followers for less than, you know, 50 cents a click kind of thing. Like, it's the dollar spend on social media goes way farther than any Google or that kind of thing. Mm-hmm. And so when I do spend on social media, I like to focus it around lead gen or boosting a press release, which maybe links to a video. So we're constantly tracking
right.
views. If it's linking back to the website, then we can determine time on site. There's tons. I really encourage dollar spend on social media, and a little bit goes a long way. And even if you're honestly, you're spending like, if you spend anywhere from like maybe $10 to $50 a day kind of thing, as you gradually, you know, go throughout the year, you're building up your presence and you're building up your audience, and
right.
especially in the off seasons for mining companies, because you can kind of spend a little bit of money and get yourself like a plateau and a presence built up, so that when the season comes out, when you're putting out more press releases, you've got a presence to actually work with at that time.
And last question, what would you say to someone who is potentially watching this and is not very good with social media, or not on social media, and they want to get started? What's the first thing they should probably do?
Talk to me. Hire me.
I was setting you up for that one. I knew that was coming.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Reach out to someone like a professional, or
yeah.
someone else that they may see on social
yeah.
media.
Or their IR them. Person. I mean,
yeah.
obviously there's a right and a wrong way to talk about your company publicly. And so you should probably consult that person or someone that has knowledge. Get them set up too. I mean, set them up and like make a nice banner image, and maybe just at least put your pitch deck on there or any kind of media information, so
right.
that, because one thing when people, like investors, do find out about your company, they will search you on Google and they'll start to do due diligence. And a lot of smaller companies haven't had a lot of media exposure yet. So when they do Google the company, nothing comes up, or just the link to their website.
Right.
So social media, by creating those channels and updating them with information, that starts including into your Google search. And so it's just great to kind of help build up your presence. And again, like a lot of, I mean, when a company has a lot of followers, I mean, that just garners a lot of trust.
Yes.
It does. I mean, whether it's justified or not, like having 100,000 followers on Twitter or something.
People think there's something there.
There is something there. And,
yeah.
like, and there should be, rightfully so. So like companies like tech or those bigger ones, they have huge followings, and
right.
obviously they're big companies, and
yeah, they can do it.
They can do it, yeah. So, but even smaller companies can do it, and on a smaller scale, even having, like, you know, you can grow up to 5,000 or 10,000 in not that long of a time period, and
away you go,
yeah.
Cool. Well, very good. Well, thanks for the insight. Great to see you, and again, it's Woah's Media, and how people get in touch with you.
Go to my website.
Yeah,
it's woahismedia.com, and that's probably the best way. Call me
there
on
go.
My phone, cell phone.
There you go. All right, we'll go to the website for sure. Rebecca, yeah. great to see you. Thanks
great
very
to
much.
Meet you. Thank you.
All right, Rebecca Kurzweil, the CEO of Woah Is Media.